Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Out Late But Great. This is going to be an interesting video because I'm sitting in my office and the sun is so bright that I'm holding a book of Chopin waltzes because it's the first thing that was sitting on my desk that was that big to block the sun so I could do this video. This week, our video... It's been a long day, people. Our topic actually came from a viewer. And I'm going to try not to drop this book while I click on here. His name is David, and he goes by the name D-Dog5858. And he gave us our topic, and the topic this week is it still important for a person to come out to their family if they don't have a significant other or prospects for one? This is really, okay, I'm going to try and hold on a second here. This is challenging. This is really a good question. Okay, I'm blue. Wow, that's really trippy. Okay. Yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's a really good question because a lot of people that I know who are gay, now, you know, half, I would say maybe half and half, they don't have partners. Yet, you know, your life and your personal being is not all about who you're with, right? So even if you are gay and don't have a partner, I think the most important reason why it is still good to be out to people is because you want people who are close to you, or let me rephrase that, you want people who you want to be close to you to really and truly know you. Okay, this might not be a good segue, but somebody really close to me just passed away on Thursday. And he was someone who I learned so much from. I've known him for the past 14 years. He was 85, and he was our conductor. He was also my conducting teacher. And not only that, he was a friend because I saw him all the time. We had meals together and shared poetry together, and I saw him frequently, you know, 3 times a week. But the reason why I'm making this a segue is the whole time, okay, up until 3 years ago, I was married and he knew me as a couple with my ex. Okay, when I came out and he found out that I am gay and that I was now going to be with Kirsten, he accepted me completely and fully. Okay. So even if I wouldn't have had her in my life, I would have still wanted him to know because we talked a lot over the past 3 years and he came to my wedding. And I can't imagine being close to somebody and trying to connect on a level that's far more than superficial and have them not really know the real you, partnered or not. Because it does change who you are. You know, I don't know about you, but it doesn't take long to have a conversation with somebody. And if you're talking with them long enough, whether you're talking about healthcare, politics, religion, whatever it is you're talking about, somehow that always seems like it could come back around to the issue of gay rights or how any of those subjects affect people who are gay. I mean, it just seems to always be a possibility to come up. And I can't imagine, you know, no, I didn't actually think about that very thing when I had to sing for his funeral today, and it was hard. It was really hard, but he had the most amazing life. And one of the things that one of his sons said in the eulogy that really stuck with me was that Everybody loved Daniel. He did not have anybody that didn't meet him and was not charmed in 5 minutes by this guy. And he was really genuine. You know, he wasn't trying to charm people. He just did. And he let you in to know the real him. And so one of his sons said something that this is going to stick with me now for the rest of my life, that the one thing that he admired about his dad is that his dad was never judgmental and that his dad always had a live and let live attitude. And I just, wow, if everybody could be like that, we wouldn't have any problems in the world. We wouldn't have anything to argue about. So, you know, you never know where you're going to get inspiration for how things tie in with videos. And I really didn't know how I was going to do this video today because I knew this was going to be a tough day. From 9:30 until almost 3 o'clock, I was, first we had a rehearsal for the funeral, and then we had the funeral, and it was a big deal. And this guy was a very celebrated composer, conductor, and there was not a seat left in that church. So all that to say that I can't imagine him not knowing me, you know? And I went back through when he passed on Thursday. I went back through some of our wedding pictures and saw him in the background in some of the pictures, and I'm also dancing with his wife. And it just, what a joy to be able to have people at our wedding who fully accepted us, that totally knew me in my life before for many, many, many years. And that's what it's all about, isn't it? Have a great week, everybody. Take good care of each other.